Hey folks, it's Glenn with the Cactus Atlas, and for the next week or so I'm going to be documenting a road trip through Utah and beyond, and taking you a little bit behind the scenes and stopping to see really cool things along the way. Let's get this started. This is one of the most iconic landscapes in the world, I would say. You can see the road out there where Monument Valley is, and we're not taking you there in this episode, although I am visiting there on this trip, just so you know. But out that a ways is one of the most iconic looking places ever. You could see Slim, our ride for the next week or so on this epic Utah road trip, and into Colorado too, actually. I love the state line. This is one of the coolest signs going into any state. And then when you go into Arizona, let's just do a comparison. It's pretty lame, Arizona. You need to step up your game here. And we're technically, I think, still in my state of Arizona. I'm not sure where the state line actually is, but here's looking back to home. I'm several hours into this trip already, but this is where I'm starting to record. And yeah, Arizona, you're pretty lame when it comes to your Welcome to Arizona signs, I must say. I usually don't like to say negative things ever on the show, but come on, you gotta give me that. Utah's got it going on with their state line signs. All right, we are officially in Utah now. And although I did say I'm gonna be stopping at Monument Valley for a standalone episode, it's not gonna be on this road trip. Although we might see some behind the scenes stuff here in the area, so just hold tight, folks, hold tight. There are a ton of scenic turnouts that we've stopped and looked at before on a previous video through Utah a couple years ago. It's been a long time. People still watch that, amazingly. Still get comments about that one. But yeah, I'm not gonna stop at every little pull off here because we're gonna be seeing Monument Valley up close and personal on this trip. But it still is a fantastic landscape. I mean, such an iconic look of the Southwest. All right, let me give you a quick update as to what this is going to be. It's been a long time since I've been able to take a pretty long road trip and make something here in anywhere other than Arizona. So I'm really excited about that. But the gist of the trip is I'm gonna be heading north in Utah from here up towards Moab, Utah, but I'm going to skip Moab this time, and we're going to head out towards western Colorado for a couple days, and I'm going to be camping along the way. Going to have some reservations for that. Going to be doing some dispersed camping if all goes according to plan. And in fact, my only day that I booked a hotel room is today, and the rest is a camping trip in open slate, really. Doing something a little bit outside my comfort zone. When I say outside my comfort zone, I'm I like guarantees, you know, I like reservations, I don't like surprises, but I'm going to such remote places that I'm just gonna have faith that I'm not gonna have trouble finding camping spots and things as I venture out. And there's plenty of backups also if I run into problems, so that's why I got this truck for, was to do more stuff like this. For now, my current destination is Goosenecks State Park, and based on watching videos, looks like a really cool camping opportunity, which I don't plan on doing this time, but the view of what's over there, this canyon where this river meanders through it, is the main centerpiece, and from what I can tell, it seems like a pretty quick stop. Get out, look at the views, enjoy it, and then head on. So it wasn't really something that looked worthy of a standalone focused video, hence why I'm doing this road trip video, to get bits and pieces of all these roadside or not off the too far off the beaten path kind of sites and things that I probably wouldn't normally stop at. Can you pick that up on the GoPro straight ahead? Those like kind of gray swirly hills with the red streaks in it, and almost like triangular patterns, like native pottery or something like that. I think there's something called the Navajo tapestry, some formation like that, and that might be it, actually. It's kind of fun, though, just to hang out here in Slim, isn't it, and just drive with me. See our beautiful country. I think this takes a sharp turn here, and we're going to face what might be the tapestry. And I actually see the famous rocket Mexican hat, which we are going to get a close-up look at today. I know in the past I saw it from a distance, but I've never driven up to it. Gonna hit Goosenecks first, then Mexican hat, and then head back, check into my quarters for the night, and we'll take it from there. Can you guys spot the famous Mexican hat rock out there? It's almost like a caricature of rocks. It's almost unbelievable. It's just this really weird balanced rock, kind of tiny. Off to our right, you could, I think, barely see it. It's about to go behind that hill. But Gooseneck should be somewhere off to our left, only about 10 minutes away, and we're gonna make a left onto 261 north here in about 3 miles. I don't know if this is gonna end up being like an hour-long thing, two-parter, four-parter. I usually get into these things thinking, oh, it's gonna be a really quick and easy video, and then ends up being like a multi-parter. What is going on here? Okay, Amy's gonna put in all the behind the scenes and my grumpiness. Like, these people in front of me need to put their pedal to the metal here. Come on. I know a few of you said you want to see the behind the scenes. So this might be the video where you get to see all the grumpy glens. There's a sign for Lake Powell and Natural Bridges National Monument, Goosenecks State Park. So many cool things to see in the state of Utah. I've said it before. Utah's my favorite state, by far, for scenic beauty. Nothing comes close in my mind that I've seen anyway yet. It's hard to say that being in Arizona and as beautiful as our state is, but we don't got as much of these red rock landscapes. And I guess this is part of Bears Ears National Monument. A lot of the stops we're gonna see, I think, might actually be part of Bears Ears Monument or on the outskirts of it. There's lots for us to explore in there that we're not going to get to see on this trip, but this is going to be pretty cool regardless. Maybe now the first or second grumpy Glen moment of the trip, as I took great care to pack the car in such a way that I shouldn't have rattling things in here, but I ran out of room in the bed of my truck because I have so much camping equipment back there. And yeah, I got a rattler here. We got a rattler! So I gotta do something about that before we hit some of these back roads on this trip, or else you're gonna be hearing that the whole time. And my keys. Someone actually mentioned my keys rattling. I'm glad they did, because I had thought of that too, and you'll notice on some videos I've started taking those off, because it does get annoying, you know? All right, I'm looking at my, like, looking at Google Maps, and like, we're coming right up on the state park. It's just, if the state park is...
Your destination will be on the right.
Yeah, here we go. Here we go. Looks like there is a check-in booth, so I don't know if we're gonna pay. Looks like the Gooseneck sign is gone. I wanted to get a picture with that. Oh well. So there is like a little gate here, and I see RVs, see a vault toilet, and somewhere right in front of me would be a 1,000-foot drop-off. I might botch this one, but I think it's probably safe to say this is the San Juan River. The one that we crossed over at Mexican Hat. It would make sense. And you can see that river flowing. In fact, I can actually hear rapids every once in a while. All right, so not too shabby, huh, for our first stop on this road trip. Hopefully it sets the right tone. This is like solid rock here. It's not like flaky dirt. So I feel pretty solid and safe. The only thing that I find slightly annoying, but also am curious what your guys' opinion is that I've really fallen in love with my drone, and this is such a landscape that is begging to be photographed with a drone. So number one, like, what do you guys think about that? I know a couple of you guys have commented early on that you hate drones, you find them annoying. I get the noise, like when they take off, they are noisy, but it doesn't take long before they're up in the sky before you can't even see or hear them. And seeing like how crowded this is here, all the people I could bother, being sarcastic, I think it's a little bit extreme in this day and age about where you can and can't fly your drone. So Utah State Parks, can I get a permit? Maybe you can, actually. You know what's pretty crazy is that I want to say this thing like winds around this way, right? And then probably that way, all the way around and back this way and back and forth again. And if we go this way, I could see like cliff walls where all the camp spots are. So let's go walk down this thing and see if we can get some different views. I almost wonder if the view's gotta be better over here because I'm the only one over here. Everybody's hanging out over this way. So that was our warm up. Here's one of the campsites. Got a nice fire ring. You literally just pull up right here and park your RV or set up your tent. Don't really see any tent campers. Be a windy place to tent camp on most days, I imagine. This could be your campsite right here where I'm standing. For me, it won't be on this trip, but maybe in the future. As with many places out here in this part of Utah, I hear the night skies are supposed to be something spectacular too. Here. I could believe it. There's really nothing here. One of the signs back there said this is considered to be one of the biggest entrenched meanders. I don't know when they say entrenched, I guess. A meandering stream that dug into a canyon, I guess is what that means, in the world. So probably a pretty rare sight to see a river that meanders this much. And you can kind of see where it got its name, Goosenecks. It just curves like goosenecks, plural. So right after you pay, I mean, other than the camp spots that fan out that way, this seems to be the main point of interest here. There's like one official lookout, I guess, where if we come here, maybe we can see all of the meanders in frame at once. Probably not in frame, but maybe a panorama. Let's see. Oh yeah, here we go. This is the spot. You can see the best from where they put the official overlook. Surprise, surprise. So you see this meander here, you see that meander, and it goes all the way around that, I think, and comes out over here, and then back again off into the wild blue yonder, or the wild red yonder. It's like if you really want to, you could climb down that and you could see a lot of foot traffic. I don't think it's a trail or anything. I just think it's another like point where you can go down and look, but it's probably better from way up here, I have to imagine. I guess not bad for stop number one on this road trip, huh? Definitely worth a stop. Definitely worth the $5, I'd say. And that's probably about it for Goosenecks. See, I told you, not worthy of making a standalone video, I don't think, unless I camped here. Then it might be. But just as a tourist today, come do your Clark Griswold and get back in the car. Okay, let's drive around Goosenecks here, down by the camping spots. We'll drive down and turn around. Maybe there's another good view to check out down that way, but I think we saw the main attraction, really. Glad it's not more than $5. $5 is just about right, I guess, for that view. I don't mind paying to support state parks, to be honest. I think that's a worthy cause, but I'm glad it's no more than $5. Looks like someone grabbed that camp spot that I was just looking at, or was thinking about it. So had I wanted that camp spot, we could have had it. There's more where those pavilions are, by the way. What is this guy doing here? Is he... He's going to be annoying. It's Grumpy Glenn. Grumpy, Grumpy Glenn. If you have time, though, and you want some exercise, you could walk the whole rim, I think. I'm just a little short on time with everything I want to fit in here. Clearly, you could see it looks like a Class A vehicle back there, so you can get a big rig down here, no problem, or up here. Like, I got a good spot. Here's a good indicator of the type of vehicle you can get back here. Probably the tiniest little thing you could think, just in case you're wanting to come visit. But anywho, there you go, Goosenecks State Park. Next stop, Mexican Hat, or the Mexican Hat Rock, I should say. So I guess it turns out if I really wanted to camp here, the prime spots were taken except for that one that I found, so I would have been lucky, although it's very close to the entrance. But after dark, I imagine there's not many people coming in and out of here. But there were other pavilions and stuff, not on the cliff side, but so there appear to be other ones. It is a Saturday, so I imagine one of the busier days to be out and about. And hopefully not an indicator of how it's going to be the rest of the trip, though. I think actually straight ahead on that hillside is the Navajo Tapestry, the thing that I was mentioning earlier. And in fact, it might just be worth stopping here in this parking lot and getting out on foot and showing you that, because that's pretty cool. Or I wonder if we'll get closer to it when I go down to the Mexican Hat. There's really no good place to pull over and see that, but right in front of me, you can see those zigzag patterns. Almost looks like someone's sweater or something like that. Those triangular patterns. It's really pretty. But yeah, unfortunately not. Everything's fenced off and barbed wired off. Power lines there, but anyway, let's head on down to the Mexican Hat Rock, which is within my field of view. I'm actually heading now south again back towards Monument Valley, so tomorrow when we leave, we're going north towards Moab, Utah. So just wanted to come and make good time, check that stuff out, use time wisely so I can see everything that I wanted to see. But I have to admit, I am getting hungry, and dinner time is not far away, and I haven't really eaten anything today since breakfast, which was just a banana. So here I might be able to get up in the air and get a good close look at the Mexican Hat Rock. It's my hope anyway. I think this is just public lands out here, not a state park or national park or anything like that. Just a quick stop with dispersed camping. There's the little sign for Mexican Hat Rock. Interesting, I guess when I hear dispersed camping, I usually think free, but apparently there is a fee at mexicanhatrock.com. But we're not camping here, so it don't matter. It's kind of lame to charge and see it listed as dispersed camping on many websites. Yeah, just a lot of old, like, you know, lots you could pull out, I guess, here and pull your big rig into. I don't know if there's a preferred way. I'm actually going to go this way because I don't want to drive in that guy's dust. We'll do the counterclockwise direction. I didn't see any signs saying one should go this way or that, so I assume this circumnavigates the rock. Wow, that rock is awesome. I can't wait to get out and show you guys. Yeah, I think these little pull-offs are probably the camping spots. Really not many people back here at all. Seems to be like a good view right over here. I don't know if there's a preferred view or not, but this might be good for my needs. And there it is, not zoomed in, but I am standing pretty close to the base of Mexican Hat Rock right there. That is quite a sight. You don't really, you could see it's precariously balanced from far off, but that is probably the best balanced rock I've ever seen. You see that? That is crazy. I wonder if that's the same, like, way it gets balanced like that, is that the stuff underneath it erodes and it's harder than the material underneath it and just ends up being balanced like that, but that can't last forever. It's really hard to know where the best view is going to be. I suppose one could drive all the way around it, but for me, getting in the air is where it's at. Just so we can go study up close how balanced that thing is. Wonder if you can climb up there too. I think this road actually goes up. I'm standing in front of kind of a makeshift road that goes up higher, but I don't think you'd have to rock climb to get to the top of that. I don't think I'd want to be up there if that thing fell over though. Really neat and probably best seen from the air, I have to say. You know, flying around that, especially when the light is illuminated behind it by the sun, it is spectacular. And just to see how precariously balanced that is. And then what I presume is the San Juan River, or some river on the other side of it. Goosenecks is on, like, over this ways, where we just came from. But I guess that's a San Juan. I don't know what other river it would be. But yeah. Lots of cool, nice camping spots back here too, but that is definitely worth stopping and checking out. There must be a boat launch down there into that river, the San Juan. Some big rafts over there. All right, the Mexican Hat, up close and personal. Last time I saw it from the main road and just stopped and took a picture. This time, we flew right up to it. And that was so cool, was so worth it. Bye, Mexican Hat Rock. All right, now to our sleeping quarters for the night so I can kind of get settled in and get some food in my belly. All right, we're crossing the San Juan again, now going back the way we came. We already crossed this once today. The San Juan Motel is down there. Not many people here. Seems like a dead town now. A lot of closed things, but same river we saw at Goosenecks. Very cool. All right, we're still on 163, but you could see the landscape off to the left, the markings of the beginning of Monument Valley. And somewhere up here is the famous Forrest Gump Hill, which I must say is probably the biggest tourist attraction out this way. It's from the scene where Forrest Gump is running down a endless road here. I think it'll probably look familiar to you once we see it. I don't know if I'm gonna stop or not. Depends on how many people are here. This place gets nuts. I wanna say this blue sign up here is an indicator that we're almost at Forrest Gump Hill. Let's see. They have signs for it now. Yep, Forrest Gump Hill, scenic view area, 1 mile. And you wanna go slow in here because you have people coming out on the road to get their picture. Trying to line up the shot with the iconic movie. You can kind of see where they have Navajo sellers setting up here on the side to sell their wares. But here you go. It actually isn't that crowded at the moment. Yeah, it is. You can see down here where everybody's kind of staged. But why do you gotta get out when you got a GoPro on the front of your windshield here? Forrest Gump Hill. Run, Forrest, run. Actually, you know what? I feel wrong if we don't stop, I think. Let me pull over here. There's just nobody here, so it just would be kind of silly not to, right? It's also a really bad time of the day because the sun's, you know, kind of facing us right now. This is facing approximately west. But you can see, I think it's clear for me to walk out in the middle of the road here. And this is why you gotta go slow, and you can see people down there getting their shot. I think that's probably the ideal spot. You gotta look behind you though, because you don't want to get run over. But yeah, the famous Forrest Gump Hill and scenic turnoff. It is something special. Even if it wasn't in Forrest Gump, it's worth stopping to see that. Yeah, the least crowded I've seen it, really, in the last few years I've been out here. Usually it's really hard. I mean, you could see people are stopping, so the last time I was here, it would have been impossible. There were just people coming and going. So this is pretty light. Oh. I stopped for you, so what else do you want from me? But a lot of people stop down there in a hill, so I wonder if that's the better place to line up the shot. Not sure. All right, Forrest Gump Hill. It's probably gonna be better driving, actually, than stopping. Pretend you're Forrest Gump right now, running at full speed towards that horizon there. Do you guys recognize this, though, from the movie? I imagine most of you do. I imagine many of you have probably been here getting your own picture. Yeah, people really have it good today. I don't really know where the movie was shot from, like where the perfect vantage point is. Otherwise, I'd run down the road for your pleasure. Plenty of scenic turnouts if you don't want to pay the fee to go see Monument Valley. This isn't really the Monument Valley proper, I think, that you would recognize. I think you can see a few of the features here and there, but if you really want Monument Valley, you gotta pay and drive down into it like we're gonna do on a separate standalone episode, actually tomorrow morning. And everything's kind of backlit right now, but you can see the silhouettes of these fantastic formations. Very magical. Our destination, I think, is off to the right somewhere. We're going to maybe one of the most popular lodges or hotels in the area, Goulding's, or Goulding's. I don't know how you pronounce it. Probably Goulding's Lodge. Only 5 miles away until we find our quarters for the night. Goulding's Lodge. So right here is where I think we want to go. I want to say there's a campground that I camped at back here years ago, like 20 years ago. This looks like what I remember. It's kind of nestled up against the rocks. It's very beautiful back here, like really large cliffs. You can't really see it though. I think it's very backlit. And where does one check in here? Is the real question. All right, I got checked in, no problem. That was quick. And now it is across the street. I have like a small villa, like a one room, like home, 500 square feet or something like that. And then the restaurant, and there's a museum and some other stuff are up this way. I don't know how much time we're gonna have for all of that. Priority number one is getting some food in my stomach for sure, because I am starving. There's Old Slim, and just take a look. This amazing landscape that Goulding's is nestled in here.
The motel proper is at the top of the hill back there where you check in, where the restaurant and museum is, and then you got all these really small homes. And out that way is Monument Valley. I heard a meowing cat, and the kitty's coming to see me. Be careful. Come here. Come here, meower. What? You gonna go see Slim? Hi. What are you doing, you? Are you a stray? What? Come. Are you afraid of me? I'm gonna go over here and check out my quarters here. And then, yeah, outside my front door is this amazing view that we're gonna get a closer look in our next video. I wanna say I see the mittens out that way. I think that's Monument Valley proper. This kitty is very, very, very talkative. Let's go see if I can pet the kitty. Hi, come, 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 here. Very skittish, but curious little being. He's hiding under Slim. Yeah, this is awesome. It's really quiet. I don't know if it's just because it's not like peak season. I thought it was gonna be busy, but this kitty keeps following me. Look, I wanna pet you and be friends, but I don't have any food for you. I know, I'm not gonna bring any food. Very talkative cat. What's your name? This is a very talkative cat. Really talkative. Come here, it's safe. You can come, I know you trust me. You're doing that back leg stretch thing. I know you trust. I know you trust. Come, I'll let you smell. Smell, smell, smell. Yeah, see, you're not sure. You're not sure, are you? You don't know what to do. You're very much like our kitties. Nice and peach. Come here. Hmm? What are you doing? Yes. I know. I want to be friends too, but you got to come see me. I gotta be careful that he doesn't follow me in here. Alright, let's do the reveal together. I must say it wants to get in here. Sorry, buddy. Oh wow, this is much more spacious than I thought it was gonna be. This is nice. This is really nice. You got a kitchenette here. Get the lights on for you. Come on. I'm trying to find all the light switches here. There we go, we're getting there. Wow, all right, let me just get the lights on and then I'll give you guys the grand tour. It was around $300, I wanna say, for one night, at least this time of the year. It was very clean, so that's the first thing. No strange stink. Sometimes places can be kind of stinky. There's some carpet, some hardwood floor, but very clean. I don't really see any stains or anything. Little leather couch, kitchenette, phone, TV, little table, some extra chairs for you, and a sink. So if you want to make your own food, I actually can if I want to. I got a microwave and all sorts of stuff and a nice fridge, and take you back here to the bathroom. Now, very nice. Very nice, very clean. I haven't seen anything to complain about yet. I'm pretty easy to please though. Take a look at the bathtub. Kind of shallow actually for a tub, but since I don't really take baths, that's not a problem. And let's go to the bedroom. Another TV, so you get two TVs, and I like how they put the bedroom into its own room here in the back, but you can see a pretty small bed. So even if you're a couple, it's like a double, so it'd be kind of tight, depending. But for one, just for me, this is all right. I have a soft spot for cats. I feel guilty and, you know, feel sad for that cat. Although I'm sure it lives out here just fine, out in the desert. Probably gets fed a lot by patrons and stuff. It's very friendly and talkative, so. But I want to let it in, but I'm not going to. I would never do that. But anyway, yeah, this place is nice. The thing that I like the best is when there's no smell, like no hotel smell or anything. Smells like a normal residence in here. No strange odor at all. It doesn't smell lived in, smoked in, or anything like that. So
Very nice. I have allergies, if I haven't ever said that before. So sometimes when you stay in these rooms, especially where you could smell it, somebody smoked in the room or something, I wake up and I don't feel good. And, you know, so it's nice when I can do the smell test and know it's going to be all right.
All right, I saw a trail back this ways that goes up against these giant cliffs. Kind of walk this way like that behind me. So let's go take a look, see what's up there. Now don't get too excited. I'm not making a really long hike here. I just want to see if we can get any good views from up this ways and take a look. I just love the way the sun though plays off of those cliffs. We'll take a look at Goulding's proper. Well, I am gonna zoom in here a little bit. I believe that those are the Mittens, very famous landmarks inside of Monument Valley, and other things that we're gonna get a good close-up look at tomorrow when we descend into the valley. But for now, it's all about my belly. It's interesting how it comes back to me too. And way back then, there's probably footage of it somewhere. I camped back there somewhere, I think in two different trips, but like 20 years ago or something like that. So I think there's Goulding's campground back there. Alrighty, so let's head back down to the little cabin. I assume that's what it's called. I didn't really look that up to see what they call these things, but kind of having a change of heart about food. I was gonna go drive back over there. There's a restaurant that's open till 9 p.m. tonight. I inquired about that, but maybe I'll get breakfast there tomorrow because I don't think Monument Valley opens till like 8 a.m. I need to look into that because last time I came here years ago, we came here at sunrise. It was still dark out and was able to get in. So maybe they changed that. And it's only 6 o'clock here, about an hour before sunset. I'm in mountain time now. I lost an hour. It's 5 o'clock back in Phoenix. So, but I just feel tired. I think I just drove so much today, did some adventuring too. I mean, I drove like 6 hours, 5, 6 hours, something like that. So that's not a trivial drive, and kind of why I decided to kind of stage here in a nice comfortable bed before I head up north into Utah and Colorado, and I'm sleeping in a tent without showers probably for, I don't know, a couple campgrounds might have the shower, but some of them will not. Here's one more view of this Goulding's lodge and cabins, whatever we're calling it. I mean, this is worth the money. I mean, it's a little pricey for my taste these days, trying to save money. That's why I'm camping, but just splurging one night, unless I wimp out later on in this vacation and decide to book a room somewhere. Hey there, this cat has like pink fur because it rolls in the pink dirt. It's really beautiful actually. It's like a pink spirit cat. Are you? Are you a pink spirit cat? You know I'm your friend. We had a petting session earlier and it was all good, but I guess you forgot already. All right, I caught up on some chores here and I've got things charging to be ready for the morrow on our grand adventure on the road. See, I'm charging drone batteries over here, charging camera batteries over there, charging GoPro, and more drone batteries over here. It's the routine, folks. It's the routine. All right, so here's the little kitchenette. Making a little bit of an organized mess. Get some of these snacks, these road snacks out of the way. And yeah, so I brought my little pot here. Here's what's for dinner, folks. Hormel chili with beans. And natural Jif crunchy. And what do we got in here? This oat nut bread for my sandwich. It's actually quite a good combo. It's got a little bit of a sweetness in the bread. I really like this one. Oro wheat. And there's a toaster if I want to lightly toast it.
All right, we'll let the chili heat up here. And I know this isn't really an interesting gourmet meal. I feel like I have to bend down or something because of the camera, but I think I have it set up okay. Brand new peanut butter for the journey. Let's do like a, let's see if I can polish this off by the end of the trip. Get a lot of peanut butter. I think I can do it though. Really making amends to eat better on this trip and try to eat more energizing foods and not fried food and French fries and hamburgers and gotta watch the belly. But yeah, this is gonna be a great trip. Yeah, we're driving way up to actually to Western Colorado. Colorado National Monument on this trip is gonna be the furthest away from home we go. And then we're gonna come back into Utah near Hanksville, Utah, where I'm gonna revisit Goblin Valley. Got some surprises and lots of fun things lined up for that with some dispersed camping. And tomorrow's actually gonna be an adventure. I'm gonna start off at Monument Valley, and I think that's gonna be my first part of the day is the plan, followed by Valley of the Gods and trying to do dispersed camping there. If you guys are familiar with that place, I don't know. It's like a free Monument Valley, they say, but I hear it's not quite as magnificent as Monument Valley, but close. And you can camp in the middle of it, so that's the plan anyway. We'll see what happens. I have a fallback, so if I fail and can't find good camping or am just really tired or something, I allowed myself the option to stay in Blanding, Utah, or maybe even drive as far north as Moab and get a hotel there for the night. Because I'll be camping for the whole week, pretty much, starting Monday. It's Saturday, by the way. And that's pretty much the plan. I didn't say every single thing we're doing. I don't want to give away all my secrets, but those are some of the major areas we're going to be plowing through here over the week. And peanut butter sandwich number one has been prepared, and now I just need to wait for the chili. Yeah, I looked at the menu for Goulding's restaurant here, and it looks really appetizing. They've got lots of really good things. I think I did see Navajo tacos on there too. But burgers, like ribeye steaks, New York strip steaks, fish. I think I saw salmon, and I also saw like beer battered cod, I think. Shrimp and fries. So there's a really varied menu, really American. And I only looked two lines on the breakfast menu, and I saw biscuits and gravy, and I was sold. It's like my usual go-to. Gotta keep the meat on these ribs. Now I'm kind of thinking I wish I was back up at the restaurant over there, but let's taste this Hormel chili out of a can. Gotta give it its due. I don't expect the world here, but hopefully it's tasty. Lots of beans, lots of energy, hopefully. Man, gotta have the peanut butter sandwich. I forgot to put honey on it, darn it. I'm not gonna go figure out where the heck the honey is. It's somewhere in the truck. But that will do just fine. There you go, Hormel chili. Didn't Walt Disney like eating chili out of a can, I heard? Oh, wow, that just occurred to me. That was like his favorite thing, I thought. I used to eat a lot of chili as a child, too. Canned chili. Probably Hormel. Feel pretty full, though, from dinner, so that's good. Hopefully we'll wake up energized and ready to attack the day. And Nintendo Switch, here I come. See you in the morning. Good morning, and excuse the bedhead. I have not showered or gotten ready yet. I don't care, it's a road trip. Look at what I see, this beautiful sight in front of me. That is amazing. Monument Valley at sunrise. I wish we could be out there. I was out there one year and I saw that with my own eyes. So anyway, I've got a little bit over an hour to pack up and get ready. And I made a compromise. I decided I'm probably not going to go get breakfast to save time, and I slept in a little bit longer, and because I lost that hour, so it's really like in the 5 a.m. hour in my mind right now. So I'm going to get everything packed up and ready, take a shower, and then take my time, eat some food here, and then we're going to get on in there, but not for you guys on this episode. That'll be a different episode, standalone episode that will be out. But for now, enjoy sunrise, which you're not going to see on the other video.
All right, here we are at Goulding's in the morning, looking for coffee and the restaurant. You could see the inn up there, and people are waking up now and getting their sun. There's animals galore here. Hey, what are you doing? You don't want to be bothered, do you? I'm going to go get some coffee. Want to come with me? You got cats. There's a cat over there, too. It's a cute dog. What's your name, buddy? What's your name? Here. Nope. And there's a sign saying the restaurant's up here. And we've got a cat here to greet us. Hey. Don't be afraid of my camera. It's not going to hurt you. I think they're afraid of the camera. They see it and they're like, what is that contraption? It doesn't look usual. This here is the historic trading post, I presume. And I see John Wayne's historic cabin behind it. I'll explain a little bit about that in a second. Let's check out some of the stuff. There's like neat things here. Here we go. It's a memorial to Harry and Leon Goulding, born in the late 1800s, early 1900s, and came out here and I think started and established what we see here. I'm really bad at imitation, so I'm gonna hold off, but John Wayne, much renowned in these areas for the films, or at least one film, if not films, that were filmed in Monument Valley. I don't know if this is an original or not, but it's still cool regardless. It's fenced off, so you'd think it's got some age to it. Is the cabin that John Wayne stayed in, presumably when he filmed movies out here, but I also wonder if he just liked it out here and vacationed here, came out here. I don't think you can go inside, but you can see it looks like it's built with a lot of the native material here in the area. Same coloration as the big cliffs in the background, but that's really cool. You can really see the construction too. It's pretty old school looking. Got mud in there. So I believe that's a oldie. Alrighty folks, let's say goodbye to Goulding's so we can get back on the road. I'm gonna head over to Monument Valley now, but I'm gonna catch back up with you guys as we head back up north into Utah.
Alrighty folks, let's hit the road again. I'm leaving, I'm heading towards Monument Valley now. I got everything packed up. Think I'm all good. And now I'm gonna go drop my keys off and also see if I could find some coffee to go. I think I saw the restaurant up there has takeout orders, so, and probably fuel up too. Seems like there weren't too many vacancies last night, so this is Easter weekend, by the way. Easter Sunday is today. Happy Easter. And the sun is bright. Hopefully when we get into the park, it's not like backlighting everything. I don't remember it doing that from the different angles we're gonna see. And by the time we get over there, sun should rise. It's about 8 o'clock now, so Monument Valley should be opening to the public right now in like 2 minutes. So like a few minutes behind schedule, but for the most part, I am keeping a good schedule. Amy would be proud.